Hi there, Guy from Bugs and Stuff and GiantSpiders.com. So, 2021 marks my 33rd year of keeping tarantulas, and after breeding many species over that time, I am particularly pleased with my recent success in breeding one of the hobby's most iconic species, Brachypelma bormi, or the Mexican fireleg. Probably one of the best known of all the tarantulas due to their bright colours, I have had this species in my collection for many years, but this was my first successful breeding. During 2018, I was lucky enough to go to Mexico for a month to photograph and film many different Brachypelma species for Andrew Smith's LoveTarantulas.com documentary, Brachypelma, the Red-Legged Tarantulas of Mexico. Having managed to find them in their natural habitat, I was inspired once again to try and breed them in captivity on my return home. I've tried to breed Brachypelma bormi in the past, but they always went on to molt without producing any egg sacs. This time around, I decided to approach it differently, and this meant giving the females a cooling down or winter period to try and get them to lay eggs. I paired up 5 females with the same male, but only one went on to produce an egg sac. So this is the female we will focus on in this film. The female molted on the 13th of December 2020, and I successfully paired them not long after on the 29th of December 2020, and then again on the 8th of January 2021. It was a textbook mating, with the male using both palps several times and with no aggression from the female. In the coming weeks, she was fed regularly but not excessively. We're often told that after mating, females should be fed as much as possible in the weeks before egg sac production, but I didn't do this with this female. In their natural habitat, females mate in the fall, become less active over the winter months, and then begin producing egg sacs in the spring. Lots of captive breeding reports recommend a cooling down period to replicate the winter months to stimulate egg sac production. So, on the 8th of March 2021, 59 days after the last pairing, I moved the female to the cool area. My spiders are kept in a converted garage attached to the side of my house, where the main animal section is heated to around 26 to 28 degrees Celsius, but the attached kitchen area is unheated, so I chose this area as my cooling area. Average temperatures in this section were approximately 21 to 23 degrees Celsius. No food was offered during this cooling period. Water was always present in the water dish, but no water was added to the substrate. The box she was in was mostly covered with a towel, so she felt secure. The substrate was a 50-50 mix of coir and sand, and on the 26th of April, after 49 days, she was moved back to the warm area and the box remained covered. I dampened the substrate a little and feeding resumed. Breeding reports recommend a progressive warming over a few weeks, but I didn't do this, her container being simply moved from the kitchen area to the animal area overnight. Although prey was offered more regularly, sometimes every day, the female wasn't overly interested in feeding. She had, though, noticeably gained weight during her cooling period, but her lack of appetite on being warmed up again was surprising. She was rehoused in a medium rub-style box to which I added lots of pieces of cork bark, flower pot hides, a covering of leaf litter, and a slightly deeper substrate. The box was covered again so she felt more secure, and average humidity inside the box was around 65 to 70%. On the 7th of May 2021, 119 days after being mated, she began building an egg sac in the half flower pot hide, and 24 hours later, it was complete. The box was then placed on a quiet shelf and remained undisturbed. I opened it to check for mold and any other problems approximately every 2 weeks. Now, most of the time, I prefer to leave any egg sacs with the female during incubation, and I chose to do this with this one too. A lot of people remove the egg sac for artificial incubation after about 30 days, but despite the risks of leaving it with the female, nothing beats seeing an adult female surrounded by her spiderlings, so I rarely remove egg sacs. On this occasion, however, I did remove the egg sac after 85 days. The egg sac looked good from day one, and I had a feeling it was healthy, as the female had cared for it for so long. Infertile or bad egg sacs are often eaten or discarded. So I removed the egg sac on the 31st of July 2021, 85 days after being laid. On opening, I was pleased to find it full of mobile nymphs that were already darkened in pre-mould. The nymphs were emptied out of the egg sac and placed inside a cricket tub lined with kitchen roll and a fine net covering. These were then placed into a larger box lined with damp kitchen roll and a secure lid with ventilation holes. This was left in the same area of the animal room as the female's container. Over the following week, the nymphs molted into fully mobile spiderlings, which measured between 1 and 1.5 centimeters in leg span, so quite large for Brachypelma spiderlings. On the 7th of August 2021, I separated 534 healthy spiderlings. So there you have it, a successful breeding of one of my favourite spiders, Brachypelma bomei, or the Mexican fireleg. Hopefully this info will help anyone out there trying to do the same.